I am Dr. Samuel George, Principal, Global College of Allied Science, Nattalam Marthandam. Very good afternoon to everybody. For my children, my students, continuously I am taking classes. Today, I am going to give the lecture about liver, mainly concerned in the physiology as well as anatomy also. You have to follow the A.K. Jain, Dr. A.K. Jain, Anatomy and Physiology for Nursing. That textbook is excellent and simplified also. Structure and special features. Structure and special features of liver. Liver is a gland. It's a gland, nothing but it's a gland. It's the largest gland in the body. This is the largest gland in the body. The weight is 1.5 kilogram in an adult. It's situated in the upper part of the abdominal cavity, occupying the greater part of the right hypochondriac region. Here, the right hypochondriac region. It consists of four lobes, which are subdivided into lobules. The lobules are the basic functional unit of the liver. What is lobule? Lobules are the basic functional unit of the liver. The liver lobules are made up of columns of hepatic cells. The outline are indistinct. The hepatic cell outlines are indistinct, forming a syncytium. It's a complex, forming a syncytium. It's very important. The lobules, which are subdivided into lobules, the lobes are subdivided into lobules. The lobules is the basic functional unit. The liver lobules are made up of columns of hepatic cells whose outline are indistinct, forming a syncytium. Outline are indistinct, but imaginary line, we have to imagine a line. The outlines are indistinct. It's forming a syncytium, it's a complex. The complex, the syncytium, I will show the picture. You have to very easily you can understand. You have to open the book and see the diagram. Now draw it as an assignment. As well as you have to prepare the note also. This is the picture of that syncytium. Lobules. Thank you so much. Again, follow me. From this picture, it's very easy to understand. The liver lobules are made up of columns of hepatic cells. Very easily you can see in the picture. The outline are indistinct and forming a syncytium, it's a complex. The portal vein divides into branches. The interlobular veins surround the lobules. The interlobular veins surround the lobules. From these vessels, blood passes between the hepatic cells in sinusoids, that is vascular capillaries, to reach the center of the lobule. That is the central vein which drain into the hepatic vein via its intralobular branches and then into the vena cava. The portal vein divides into branches. The interlobular vein surrounds the lobules. The branches of the interlobular vein, the branches of portal vein, surrounds the lobules. From these vessels, blood passes between the hepatic cells in sinusoids. That means sinusoids means vascular capillaries to reach the center of the lobule. The central of the lobule contains the central vein, which drains into the hepatic vein via its intralobular branches, small branches joined together and forming the hepatic vein, the intralobular branches, then into the vena cava. Finally, the hepatic vein drains into the vena cava, inferior vena cava. Similarly, the hepatic artery divided into branches which accompany those of the portal vein between the lobules. Ultimately, hepatic artery blood also enter the sinusoids where it mixes with the blood from the portal vein. Kupffer cells, K-U-P-F-F-E-R, are part of macrophages, reticuloendothelial system, which lies along the endothelium of the sinusoids at regular intervals. Bile is formed in tiny vacuoles in the interior of hepatic cells, hepatocytes. Bile is formed in the tiny vacuoles, like acinus, tiny vacuoles in the interior of hepatic cells, hepatocytes, and is discharged through fine canaliculi, that is like a duct, canaliculi, into interlobular bile ducts, which join via interlobular bile ducts to form the right and left hepatic ducts. These ducts join outside the liver to form common hepatic duct. You can understand very easily. Take the picture. You can see the central vein. The central vein is in the center of the You can see the sinusoids, that means capillaries, in the brown color it is not. Say in between this central vein and the portal vein, there's a imaginary line. You have to imagine the portal triad is situated in the junctions, we can say. Junctions. Portal triad means hepatic artery, portal vein, and the bile duct. Portal vein, the bile duct, hepatic artery. This is a triad, is situated in a place just opposite the central vein. Central vein will be draining into vena cava. Portal vein and hepatic artery are coming together and supplying the blood to the sinusoids. If the blood It's a sinusoids means its capillaries. Portal vein also giving blood into the sinusoids. Hepatic vein, hepatic artery also giving blood to the sinusoids. Inside the sinusoids, both the portal venous blood as well as hepatic artery blood, arterial blood, used to mix. And finally, the mixed blood will go to the central vein. And this central vein joined together, and finally, that will go to the vena cava for the systemic circulation. This is the basic concept of liver. The sinusoids are vascular, nothing but its vascular capillaries. Again, I'm telling, the liver lobules are made up of columns of hepatic cells whose outline are indistinct, forming a syncytium. What you are seeing as a round structure in this picture, that is a syncytium, imaginary line, the white line, what you are seeing is actually imaginary. For the understanding, to understand, the picture has been drawn like this. The portal triads, then and there it is spread out regularly, you can see. The central vein is inside the hepatocyte, inside center of the hepatocyte cell. The portal triad contains portal vein, hepatic artery, bile duct. Understand? Central vein is draining the blood and sending the blood to the systemic circulation. Then only the food particles will be metabolized. The metabolized food particle, the calorie, the metabolized food particles will be absorbed from the liver, This is the importance of the liver. Just muck up the why heart, the picture. Very easy to understand. It's a hepatocyte. Picture A, the magnified transverse section of a liver lobule. The directions of the blood flow and bile in the liver. The B picture is showing the directions of the flow of blood and bile in the liver lobule. The central vein is there, then hepatic macrophages, Kupffer cells, bile canaliculus, hepatocytes, branches of portal vein, bile duct, branches of hepatic artery. The picture in the said book, what I have told. Kupffer cells are part of macrophages reticuloendothelial system, which lies along the endothelium of the sinusoids at regular intervals. Kupffer cells. Bile is formed in tiny vacuoles in the interior of hepatic cell, hepatocytes, and is discharged through the fine canaliculi into the intralobular bile duct, which joined via intralobular bile duct to form the right and left hepatic ducts. These ducts join outside the liver to form common hepatic duct. This is the maximum knowledge to understand about the liver. Kindly, by heart everything, and go through repeatedly, and take it as an assignment. And while coming back to the college, please note down, prepare essays, everything, and come back. Then functions of the liver. It's very important. major function of the liver are given in the table 6.1. In this book, 6.1, you have to go through that. Anyway, I can explain little. Bile is secreted continuously by hepatic cells into the bile capillaries from where it is collected by the hepatic duct, which joins with cystic duct to form the common bile duct. Between the periods of digestion, the tone of sphincter of Oda is high. Therefore, bile is diverted via the cystic duct into the gallbladder, where it is concentrated and stored. Between the periods, the digestion, the tone of the sphincter of Oda is tight. It's not allowing bile to come out. Therefore, that's what continuously the bile is not flowing. Bile will go and accumulate through the cystic duct into the gallbladder. Where it is concentrated and stored. In the gallbladder, the bile will be getting concentrated and the gallbladder will store the bile. Composition of the liver bile. The daily secretion is 1000 ml. Daily secretion is 100 to 1000 ml. Transparent alkaline fluid. It's a transparent alkaline fluid. Light golden yellow in color. pH 7.8 to 8.6. Water, 97% it's water. Bile pigments are there. Electrolytes, fatty acids and cholesterol. Bile salts are the sodium and potassium salts of bile acids. Of the total bile salts which enter the duodenum, 90 to 95% are reabsorbed actively from terminal ileum in portal vein and returned to liver to be excreted again, so-called enterohepatic circulation. The bile salts which enter the duodenum, 90 to 95% are reabsorbed actively from the terminal ileum in portal vein and returned to liver to be excreted again. So it is called a enterohepatic circulation. The remaining 5 to 10% enter the colon and excreted together with feces. Remaining 10% enter the colon and excreted together with feces motion. Understand what is enterohepatic circulation. Entero means intestine, hepatic means liver. Enterohepatic circulation, the circulation between the intestine and the liver. The bile always secreted from the livers coming through the hepatic ducts into the, through the cystic, because of the high tension in the sphincter of Oda. It is getting collected in the gallbladder, and where it is getting concentrated, and it's a storage place, gallbladder. Then it will be secreted into the intestine. In the intestine, terminal part of the ileum, through the portal vein, it will return to the liver. The terminal part of the ileum will absorb 95% of the bile, and it will be enter into the portal veins, portal circulation. It will go back to the liver for resecretion. Again, it will be resecreted. This is a circulation. Again, it will come to the duodenum, then ileum, then again back to the liver. It's a circulation. That's what it is. Enterohepatic circulation. Ileum is the place where it absorbed. Another 5% will be excreted out through the feces. Actions. Hydrotrophic action. Bile salt combined with lipids to form micelles, that is water soluble complex, from which the lipids can more easily be absorbed. Hydrotrophic action. Making the lipids to be absorbed very easily. The bile salts, making the lipids to be absorbed very easily. Bile salts combining with lipids to form micelles. It's a water soluble complex. Lipid soluble. Bile salts, by decreasing the surface tension, are responsible for emulsification, that is breaking of fat. Bile salts, by decreasing the surface tension, it is responsible for emulsification, breaking of salts. Bile salts also play a role in activating lipase in the intestine. Bile pigments, bilirubin and biliverdin and its derivatives. They are formed from the globin protein of hemoglobin after the destruction of the old RBCs in reticuloendothelial system. RBCs are, after their life period, they will be destructed. The destructed RBCs through the reticuloendothelial system, the bilirubin and biliverdin are formed. Bilirubin, biliverdin are derived from the globin portion of hemoglobin. Heme plus globin. The globin, that is hemoglobin. Globin portion will give the bilirubin and biliverdin after the destruction of the RBC. They are responsible for golden yellow color of liver bile. The bilirubin and biliverdin are responsible for the golden yellow color of liver bile. They are only excretory products and have no digestive function. They doesn't have any digestive function. Functions of bile. Bile salt functions. Useful in digestion and absorption of fats. Useful in absorption of fat-soluble vitamins. Neutralization of acid. Bile is the substance which is alkali in nature, which is useful to neutralize the acid chyme from the stomach. The food particles coming from the stomach is having a lot of hydrochloric acid. That's why it's acidic. It's acidic chyme from the stomach. Because of the bile, it will be neutralized. Excretion. It removes many drugs, toxins, bile pigments, and various inorganic substances, copper, zinc, mercury. Control of bile secretion, nervous regulation and humoral, the hormonal regulation. The vagal stimulation increases bile secretion. The vagal nerve is the nerve supplying the liver also, 10th cranial nerve. Vagal stimulation increases the secretion by contraction of the gallbladder and relaxation of the sphincter of Foley. In between the digestion periods, the sphincter of Foley is highly tensed and it never is to open frequently. For that only the bile is storing there. Because of the vagal stimulation only, it will be, the sphincter of Oddi will be opened, the relaxation of the sphincter of Oddi. Hormonal, humoral regulation, acid, products of carbohydrates, fats and protein, digestion in the stomach and small intestine increase the release of the hormone secretin. Because of the digestive process, the secretin secretion will be increased and cholecystokinin, pancreocymin, CCKPZ from the duodenum. Secretin and cholecystokinin, pancreocymin will be secreted from the duodenum because of the digestive action also. Most potent stimulus, most convenient stimulation for liberation of cholecystokinin, pancreocymin are fat and products of protein digestion. Whereas acid in the duodenum is the major stimulus for secretin release. Acid is the stimulus for secretin release. One second. Secretin and cholecystokinin, pancreocymin hormones increase biliary secretion by contraction of the gallbladder. Thank you so much. This is the importance about the liver. Functions of gallbladder also you have to notice. One function is storage of bile, capacity is 60 ml. Second function, control of flow of bile flowing a meal. Third function, reduce the alkalinity of the stored bile. Rapid absorption of bicarbonate, sodium chloride, decrease the bile pH from 8.6 to 7.4. Gallbladder secretes mucin, which makes the bile thick. Thank you so much. Kindly go through the textbook also. Take it as an assignment and draw all the diagrams very neatly. Prepare short notes, essay questions. While coming back to the college, please bring down. God bless you. Thank you so much.